We'll be right back. Hello and good evening to the first week of XTC, of the pairing process between Team Germany and Team Lithuania / Latvia, right here, right now. Thank you everybody for joining me. It's a match of giants, right? Team Germany, heavy favorite to make it out of groups. But also the Baltic team with Lithuanian and Latvian players. Pretty strong around here. We know Anestas Ezagel being very successful with two ship list. We have seen Kaspers going to the top 4 of the GSP, I think, qualifier or even one of the Ace Championships. So the Baltic team has a pretty strong core. Let's see what both team captains will do. For the German team, we have team captain Benedikt on the go. For team Lithuania, let me check. The names are difficult. Team captain Thomas representing his team. Let's see what the players will do. We see secret areas ready to make all the cards. I think both team captains try to use TTS voice to talk with each other while having Discord in the background for the team. So it's not working right now. You can also see the special pairing cards we have prepared for the pairing process here for Team Germany with the XTC Germany logo, but also for our friends of Africa from Scotland, Iceland, New Zealand, Ukraine, Peru, and for Team Latvia and Lithuania, cards probably already in the hidden zone. While we're waiting for the captains to deal with the technical issues, let's take a look, not that one, no, that one, at the list of both teams. For Team Germany, Rebels are going in with Han Solo, Jake and Wedge, the Imperials with the Baron Swarm, Scum plays Probots, Resistance plays BB Rookies and Rose, First Order with the Malorus Swarm and Funrek, Republic with Jedi Aces and the Separatists, of Surprise with Zemgo and Jam. The right side for Team Baltic, Rebels are playing a named A-Wing Swarm. Imperials with the Scimitar, Iron Missile and Iron Torpedo, Thermal, Bomber Swarm. Gun plays Jank with Torani, Tostero, Garmut and Genesis with a Proton Torpedo. Resistance gets Poe as an ace together with three I-5 A-Wing Wingmen. First Order gets another Malorus Swarm, but only with Cadets. Republic has Ahsoka and Chopper with two Delta 7B Jedi and a Y-Wing Torpedo Bomber. And Separatist, surprise, surprise, another Zam and Jango list. It was a mistake, chat! It was a misclick. We will delete all the bots, all the VODs. We'll delete the archives, you will never find out. The boss captain's doing some small talk in the TTS chat. Do we want to listen to that? Hello, Edgar. I'm not scared. Like, I'm pretty relaxed. I'm more scared about streaming the Scotland vs. Ukraine match later, because there are some, like, issues with the overlay and XWS right now. I'm more scared about that. Alright, Team Germany is starting. We have the first attack from Team Germany and the first attack from Team Lithuania and Latvia. Team Baltic, look at those pretty flags. Team Germany starts with First Order. And Team Baltic starts with the Galactic Empire, which means... go to my file here. Germany with First Order. Galactic Empire. For our Baltic friends. Those are the attacking teams. And now both team captains can choose two of their own lists to defend against the enemy attacker. They can put it in these fields. Here, here, and here, and here. And then the attacking team can choose which of the two defending lists they want to face. Yes, the opponent chooses the exact matchup. Like, you see, to possible defense list, and then the attacking team can choose either one of those. So it's a little bit, a lot like play and counterplay involved in the team pairing process. And honestly, I'm not smart enough for that, right? Like, that's the reason why I'm not the team captain. I just let smarter people do all the work. Interesting choices here for both, right? Like, starting with swarms, with a Malorus swarm and a Scimitar swarm, I think that's a safe choice, actually, right, for both. Like, in the first round, anything can happen to you on defense, which means you go for a list which is, like, strong against almost everybody, and I think swarms are that in the current meta. Team Germany already ready with the defense. Team Baltic needs a little bit more time. I know that both team captains are on Discord with their team. Discuss strategy. Which also means I didn't get invited for our own team Discord. So that's how much our team values my input. Alright, defense list are ready, so we can reveal. Against Germany's first order, we have Resistance and the other first. Oh, a mirror matchup possible. And for the attacking Galactic Empire, Team Germany chooses for defense the Resistance. And also the Empire mirror match, maybe. Interesting choices. Yeah, hello Marcel! Good to have you here. Yeah, both choosing Resistance and the mirror, right? Like, interesting. And now both captains take the defense list, most likely looking at the PDFs about all the lists, and then choosing one of those for the matchup. Hello, Vuk! Friend from Serbia. Again, Bienet, Captain Germany, being very quick on the decision, already getting the defense card ready. Man, I don't want to see a Malorus swarm mirror, right? Like, oh, yikes. Like, no hesitation at all for Team Germany in what they want. I don't think it's gonna be the first order mirror, but what do I know? Like, again, I didn't get invited to the team Discord to discuss strategy, so I have actually no idea. I'm just here for my looks, right? And for being humble and streaming. Oh, Ezekiel says, our insider for Team Baltic, the captain messed up and put down the wrong card. I don't know, Ezekiel, right? Like, let the captains decide what to do with that. Alright, and both matchups are picked now. Let's reveal! Hopefully soon. Team Serbia preparing with the pairings with Mexico tonight. Love it. Alright, we have the mirror matchup. Team Germany against Team Baltics. First order in Team Germany's Empire with Baltics Empire. Like, wow, I didn't expect that, but that's the reason why I'm just streaming and not being captain again. Alright, let's do it. First order against First Order and Empire against Empire. Let's talk about that a bit, right? For the German side, we have a normal Malorus Swarm with Cadets and Funrek as the A6 pocket ace in the list, 200 points. Team Baltic takes the same list, but just filling out everything with more Cadets. What do we think about that? I think the role of the initiative first player role off will be important, right? That will be super big for the first order against first order matchup. Like, whoever can fly first to block will most likely have a big advantage in the game. Also, Team Germany losing a ship for getting Funrek as I6 ace. That could be a big thing in the endgame, right? Like, you're trading your Malorus, you're trading a couple of Cadets. And then in the endgame, you maybe have, like, a Funrek, a Baron, and another Cadet up in the air against a couple of more Cadets on the other side. I think I like Funrek's chances. But again, first player role will be important. Super important here. Talking about the Empire mirror match. It's a Scimitar swarm full with iron missiles, iron torpedoes, thermals, I think even tracers on board, like lots of ordnance and beef on the Baltic side. Hello Fabi, nice to see you. It's a lot to chunk through, right? And all the terminals, like, I'm not afraid of one or two terminal bombs to fly over, but I'm very afraid if, like, there are 10 on the board. And that's what you get with a Scimitar Empire Swarm on the right for Team Baltic. Germany takes the Empire Baron Swarm on the other side. That's, like, I remember correctly, 6 Barons with tracers and prockets and everything. So in the initial joust, that should be kinda an advantage first for the Barons, especially against so many enemy ships. Will be quite easy to align the Bull's Eye for prockets and maybe get a tracer off for the double modified prockets. That will be an interesting matchup, right? Because if the Barons cannot kill enough bombers in the initial joust, the initial engagement, they will suffer for sure from all the control, from all the iron missiles and iron torpedoes, and the thermal bombs. Barbie asking, how did you decide, as Team Germany, if Sasha or Timo will play Scum? I think it was like a pretty easy decision to just let Timo do his thing. And Sasha is actually like pretty good in several factions, so... yeah, this is like too, like, I'm not sure if any of the both teams has won one of each these matchups already. Like, I wouldn't bet on any winner in either of the two matchups. And again, Team Jim. Oh, somebody is. What are you doing? Let me complain to the captains, killing the room. I mean, that's also the reason why these two guys are captains, right? Like, they're good at captaining, but not good at anything else, most likely. Yeah, some are, like, one of these captains, they clicked on something not good, so the room got deleted, so we have to reload the room. Yeah, let's get it back. Alright. Right, Christopher, like, I wouldn't trust our two captains to do anything at all here. Alright, we got the table back, we got the pairing cards back. I told them which squads with factions are already deleted, so I think. While we have that little break here for thinking, look again at those custom country pairing cards we prepared for the whole group. A little gift from Team Germany. Like, just looking at the flags, right? Like, my favorite is Team Iceland. Like, that's a very classic and beautiful flag with the double cross in blue. Scottish flag is a little bit derp, and I had, like, super problems finding a good Scottish flag on the internet, actually, to put on the card. Ernie, player from Team Baltic, saying in the chat, we are gonna play 5 mirrors. I'm okay with that. I take the resistance mirror any day. And let's talk about Team Lithuania, right? Like, Team Lithuania getting foreign mercenaries on the team, actually being Lithuania and Latvia. Like, imagine if Team Germany could, like, get, like, the Swiss and Austrian guys on our team for the super team. People would crucify us, but no, Baltic players getting together, trying to form their own Baltic super team. Alright, back on the board. Germany ready, welting for Captain Baltic. Team USA and Team Canada together as a super team would be also scary, like, oof. You can form many X-Wing super teams. And next attack, Resistance, Poe and Wingman for Team Baltic, and Sam and Django for Team Germany. Actually, let's put the music back on, right? Like, we're waiting for the captains to... Man, streaming is hard. Like, I have so much respect for Dion and Scott doing that every day. Back on track. Team Germany again, super fast, super quick, super efficient. It's all about the work. I mean, Fabi, you know Carly Toolman, right? Andreas from Vienna. Good old Wien. He's a pretty good Austrian player. Hello, Chris. We are trying to do the pairings for Team Germany versus Team Lithuania, and you know how captains are, right? Like, a little bit lagging in the technical expertise, so that was a bit of buggy things in the beginning. I don't think we will destroy Team Baltic, actually. Like, those lists on that side, like, can be plenty strong. Depends a little bit on the matchups. And again, the first two matchups, First Order against First Order and Empire versus Empire, I think those twos are pretty even just from the list. Right, defense is ready. Let's reveal the defense cards. Team Germany defending with Rebels and Republic against the Resistance. Team Baltic defending also with Rebels and Scum against the Saboteurs. Oh, I don't like that. Ah, right. Back on track. So, Team Germany defending with Rebels. Alright, both captains are using the hidden sound so we can't spy on them. See the actual thought process. Ah, don't like it. Let's see what the captains decide. This time it's... Oh, it's still Team Germany being super fast. Those rabbits and scum for defense here, right? So, Torani, Tostero, Gamut, Genesis, Jank, rabbits. Sam and Django have a bit better time against... Campus the A-Wings? A lot of 3 agility, right? And... like Torani is like super dangerous with the bullseye effect. I think Team Germany chooses the Winks. Like, especially with the double shot from the Zam and the range one shots and the bombs and everything. Have a good time against A-Wings, right? Alright, in Lithuania, Latvia, Team Baltic. Right here in defense. Let's see the matchups. For real. Zam and Django against the Gum Jank. For the first matchup, and the second is Rebels, Han Solo, and mates against the Resistance. Update that in our overlay. Alright, more interesting matchups now. Let's think about that, right? Germany going with the classic Zam and Jangle. This, like, no surprise for anybody here. Surprise for anybody who is into a competitive X-Wing. It's just a strong list and strong against so many things. Having to face Turani, Jostero, Gamut, Ki, and Genesis. And Genesis Red has a proton torpedo on board. I know that. I think Zam and Jango should have it in the back right, but if you are in a bit of a wrong position to get Bullseye, to get Jostero, to get Proton Torpedo, can lose one of the fire sprays very quickly. But then against four ships, I mean, Zam and Jango, they can eat four ship lists every day, right? We've seen that in the Firecast finals, where Lukasz Kolonka to Zam and Jango against the Rebel Atani from Andrew Oehler. From Canada, the same Andrew who won Moncala for the recent GSP tournament with this list. He utilized his bomb so well and just deleted like the four ships. Yeah, San Jack and Wedge, that's catch for Germany. Catch against Poe and 5 A-Wings. 5 screwily A-Wings. I mean, in the end, Han and Wedge should like delete the A-Wings, right? I think for the third and fourth matchup, we have like a slight advantage Team Germany. Just for my gut feeling. Especially with Han having a bit against Poe. Hello, Crimson Aces Frankfurt. I'm not sure about Samgo against the Scum Jank, but I think in the Han Jank Wedge matchup against Poe and the A-Wings, the Rebels should have, like, the advantage. Alright, let's go. Next attack. Germany with the Jedi Aces from the team captain attacking and Rebels on the other side. Put that in the overlay. I think Jedi Aces are actually our weakest list in Team Germany. Like, they are so matchup dependent. Jedi Aces. Here are Obi and Anakin with autoblasters and marksmanship and all the tricks in the ETL2. Then there's a Plo Koon with CLT as support. Super AC list, not much of a bit. They will do well against like low health ships, right? With autoblasters out of arc, automatic crits and all the droids and marksmanship shenanigans. Alright, defense. Ready? Let's go. Republic against Republic. And Rebels against the Resistance. It's me! I play against Rebels. Against Fire. I kinda like it. Like, I have beef and I have lots of firepower to delete A-Wings. I think I can deal with 5 named Rebels A-Wing. And that also means the last matchup will be automatic. That's what's left on the board. And that's it for the matchups. For the pairing, Team Germany against Team Baltic. Let's go from the back. Probots against Zam and Jango. That's hard. That's super hard. I mean, it's Timo Rabe flying Probots, right? Like, he is a very good player. Very, very good player, but against another very strong two-ship list. And we know Anestas, Azaghal in the chat, will be playing Zam and Jango, and Anestas is also killing it on TTS, going deep into the cuts of like Kyber events of GSP. I have to give the advantage here, I think, to Team Lithuania, Team Latvia, Team Baltic in that matchup. Resistance, Beefy, Rookies, and Rose against 5, I think, named A-Wings. I think that's even a pocket somewhere hidden. I like my chances actually. Like, it's a 3 agility swarm, right? Everybody knows I hate that. Everybody knows that. I have the firepower, I have lots of arcs, and it's not like 5 A-Wings can arc dodge me all the time. So, in this matchup, I like my chances. Republic Jedi Aces against Republic Ahsoka, Jedi, and Wyvern Torp. Like, in theory, should be pretty doable for the aces to arc dodge everything all the time. In practice, anytime Obi or Anakin or Plo Koon is just close into the firing arcs of everybody, they will die. So, oof, skill dependent matchup. Rebel, Hanjack, Wedge against Poe and A-Wings with Rebel's side winning the bit. I think that goes to the Rebels to catch. Eno with his own Zam and Jango list against Scum Jank. I also think that's an advantage for Team Germany. Empire with Empire and both First Order versus First Order. The mirror matches, I think, are even. Pretty even. Thank you, Wook. Good luck to you too, to your team against Mexico. Hello, X-Wing 8G. You're too late to see the pairings live, but you can see the results right now on screen. I'm thinking about matchups, like. I mean, I'm biased, right? I'm a player for Team Germany, so I think we have a good chances to take away the win in the end. But there are for sure some hiccups. Hello, Sim. It's a perfect channel for fun. In around 30 minutes, we will take a little break right now, soon, but in around 30 minutes we will have a live stream of an XTC match between Scotland and Ukraine, and both captains will be playing. Put that on screen, right? A1300 UTC. Scotland versus Ukraine. That's the next thing we will do on the channel, and until then, little break here, thinking about our matchups, thinking about our life choices. I will let the channel run, like, so you guys can see everything. Change the music. Let's do. What do we want to do? Let's do synthwave, right? Synthwave is great. Marcel. Why are you trash talking already? Like, come on. You have to first make it out of groups with Team USA. Alright, see you guys in around 30 minutes from now for the XTC match, Scotland vs Ukraine. In the meantime, think about these matchups. Tell me what you think. Who will win, Team Germany or Team Baltic? See you later. Marcel, I saw the emoji you sent. That's the trash talk emoji. Come on, the poop emoji. That's not a nice one. Yeah, sub, I agree. First Order Mirror will be about first player roll off. 100%. Empire vs Empire, right? Like, who will win? Like, the Baron Pocket Swarm with Tracers or the Iron Control Thermal Swarm? Like, I'm a bit afraid for the German team actually here. There's so much beef and so much control and bomb. I'm honestly a little bit concerned. I think our Zam Jango against Scum should win. I think our Rebels against Resistance should win. Republic, skill dependent? Like, how much trust do I have in our team captain? Honestly, not that much. It's a bit beefy, right? Like, he has problems with beef with his aces. Let's see, he's skill dependent. Resistance against A-Wings, this is interesting. This is my matchup, what I have to play. Daniel, you were the first. Know when we schedule our matches. Yeah, Germany should win, but it's fun to see an upset, right? Like, I'm afraid of the upsets. Like, every single team in Group B is ready to kill Team Germany, right? Like, they don't care about going to the finals, they don't care about the overall tournament standings. Everybody in this group will just win, want to win against Germany. Boy, boy, boy. Rebel, A-Wings, Swarm. I think I can manage that. What can they do? They can shoot with two dice, right? I'm not afraid of two dice. I should get it. I have to be confident, right? And then scum. This is a hard matchup. Like, we know Teemo is an excellent player, but Ezreal is also an excellent player. And it's pro bots with this Zam and Django. Like, oh boy. I think this one goes to Team Baltic. But yeah, like, when we know the schedule, you will most likely see lots of German games on the X-Wing HHG channel from Daniel, or as a resident streamer. I won't stream any German games because that's just way too open for corruption and cheating stuff and all that. So I will stream. I will happy to stream any other country. I will not put my fingers on Team Germany. Not proper. Alright, chat, I will see you in around 30 minutes from now for the XTC match.
We'll be right back.
Alright. Who's active in the chat? I see people want to play games while we wait for the Scotland vs. Ukraine match. I don't have stream radars updated right now. Gartic phone? We're out of the Gartic phone meter, right? Let's do GeoGuessr. I'm partial to GeoGuessr multiplayer battle right now, but we can do that, right? Putting the link into the chat. Everybody can join. You don't need to register. Join the lobby, and you can rename yourself. So we know who you are. Let's play a bit of GeoGuessr while we wait for the XTC match to start. Perfect, we have the first player joining. Rename yourself, so make it easier to know who is who. Counts a fun work. Dude, I'm just a small time streamer here. Just trying to find my way in the world. Hello, Vomprat Open! I'm gonna repost the link in the chat. Last chance to join the game if you like to. It's free. I saw the beginning of the island pairings, but then I had to prepare my own stream. So how confident is Team Ireland against Wales after the pairings? Alright, nobody joining, so we play 87 countries around the world. 3 minutes. 5 rounds, right? Let's do 5. No, we don't have time for 5 rounds, actually. Let's do 4 rounds and 2 minutes. That is perfect. Right. Player joining. No, Lou, you're gonna recognize Canada, right? Like, I had problems with Canada. New players, you can rename yourselves, so make it easier for us to know who you are. I click on your name stuff here and you can rename yourself. I'd like to. I see what bread. Alright, let's start. We have to get ready for the next match. So, start now. Let's go. Alright, don't peek on stream, right? Like everybody who plays with me. Don't cheat. Alright. Nothing going on here. Driving on the right side of the road, right? So not a British colony. Looks a bit dry, so maybe in Africa, maybe in Australia. We need shields, we need signs, we need help. Lou, on your own screen you should see your own Google Street View right now, and you have to go around and try to find a clue. And if you find a clue where you are, you can guess on the map on your right hand side. I saw a truck, right? That was a truck. A truck like that. That's... B. James Mobiles? Flex? Flex? Oh boy, I don't know where we are. Like, just looking at all the stuff here, this looks like Arabia, right? Like, maybe Egypt? North Africa? Yeah, it very much looks like the Arabian island, or maybe Egypt here. Like, just from the infrastructure and the plants we see. I've been in that area before for work and very much like that, but we need more clues, right? And how much time? 20 seconds, oh boy. I need more clues, give me some clues. Yeah, that's mosque here, right? Like with the tower to call for prayer. Ah, I have the clue. Yeah, let's say Egypt here, right? Like, not a better idea. Alright. It was actually in Tunisia. Oh boy. Oh, not good for me. But we have Fabi and Cancel Funwalk. That should be Nico City Greg. Having very good guesses on the lead right now. Nice. Also player 3 with match points. Funwalk. Very far behind. Who was that? Is this Lou? No, that's Court of Garlic Phone in Kazakhstan. Oh boy. Didn't let you do anything. Lou, let's try it again, right? Next round. Oh, Fabi found a Tunis sign. Nice. That is a good thing. I didn't find any signs at all. Alright, let's go to the next round, guys. Lou, let's try to move around, right? You can use your mouse or your keyboard. Move around, and then on the map, you have to click on your guess. Okay, let's take a look at the... it's on the right side, right? So, not a colony. Oh, that looks a bit like South America. No, that's not South America. I just saw the sign. That's not South America at all. But I think my guess is in a very big country, actually. Oh boy. Alright, need more clues. We need more clues. Alright, chat, we have our clues. I will change my guess. Here, right? Like, I don't want to cheat, but if people know the country codes of the telephone, that's a very good clue here, but I don't want to Google that, and I have no idea what's not it. But from the type base, I think I recognize that. So I have an idea, but we need more clues, right, to nail it down. A bit more mountainous regions, maybe here? There. Nope, you have to click on the map, Lou, it's super easy. Click on the map where you think your location will be. Oh, there was a sign, a little one, right? Is that helping us? Is that maybe a road number? Like on the highways in America? Alright. not the right number. Not the right number at all, but like, oh, damn it. Yeah. Getting closer, maybe, right? Alright, let's just guess somewhere. Alright, I thought it was in South Korea, right? Yeah. Yeah, nice. We have the anonymous player 890 being the best guest here, but I wasn't too far. Oh, I should have stayed here, right? I knew it was the mountainous region with mountains and hills. I should have stayed here. Just went in this direction. But we have SubChatShock are also being pretty good. Cancel Funwalk, Nico City, doing fine as well. Leading right now. Barbie, also a good guess. Who guessed America? That wasn't America, man. Did you see the signs? Mexico? Canada? Alright, let's go. Next round. This is easier, right? This is quite a lot easier. I'm not driving on the left side. No, back. Uh-huh. That's a good clue, right? Now just to find it on a map. Oh, I'm so bad in this region of the world. Oh, chat, help me. Let's try to nail it down, right? Like, I think we have the... It's not a cheat, right, man? Like, you have to use all the clues you can get on the card, on the map you are given. That's not a cheat, Maui. How do you join the game? I started a round already, so you can join later maybe if you play another round. I will post a link into the chat and everybody with the link can join, but this round is already running. Oh, this is good. That's what we like, right? Okay, let's go. Do we recognize something? Yes, we recognize that. 75 kilometers away from that. We recognize more. Here. 20 kilometers. Like that, right? I think it's a very good guess. I think we got this time. We nailed it. Sorry, hot off garlic bread, but I hope you can fix it soon. So you can join us again. Ah, Nickel City! Nickel City! Dude, that was cheating for sure. Right, come on. Look at that. 2 kilometers. What? Oh my. Come on, Marcus, I'm 5 Twitch. There could have been any arbor, right? Like, come on, it's Africa. There's arbors everywhere. Okay, that next round. We need to continue with the game because the match is starting soon. Yeah, this is a good clue, right? This is a very good clue. Just need to find more info. I think it is, right? Is this worth it down the country? Yeah, nah, I think that's fine. This time we stay in the mountain region. Right, well, this looks different, actually. Try on the right side of the road, this is good. Nah, that should be, right? That should be. Oh, I'm actually not sure. No, that should be right. That's the script here. We're playing GeoGuessr, Michael, together in the multiplayer lobby. So everybody gets the same clues and have to guess on the map where we are in the world. And you can use like tricks like looking at on what side the cars are driving, right? Like driving on the right side, that's like normal people. Driving on the left, that's the colonies. That's not helping at all, people. You get better clue. I don't speak the language! Like, the best thing is, like, if you land on a highway and you can find, like, big signs with the road number and big cities and stuff like that. But without that, it's a little bit hard, actually. Especially if you can't read the script. Right? Cancel fun park, Greg! That is cheating for sure! Look at him. Being a little bit closer than me here, but Sub Hedgehog! Very good guess again in South Korea. Alright. Next one. Yeah, this was the final round actually. Final round and see the result. Cancel fun walk, Craig from Nickel City. Wins the game with literally just reading the signs, man. He's a professional. Bobby, die too, on the second place. An anonymous player number 890 on third place. And just in fourth place, me, myself. Failing this time, not being great. Alright. Thank you everybody for playing the game. We can play it later after the XTC match, maybe. But for right now, we go back preparation for the stream. Players are already ready, I heard. Fabi? Yes, let's do co-commentary, right? Like, I will call you.
Hey, hey.
Hello, Fabi, my very Liechtensteinian friend. Let's talk a little bit so I can adjust your volume.
Yeah, talk, and more talking.
Very good. Sounds great. So we have Fabi from Team Switzerland, actually, because his own country is too small.
But I'm a double citizen, so I count for...
All right, double citizen. Cheater, actually.
I'm a cheater. That's it. Oh, I like the list of the Scotmen, actually. I already decided who won this game. King Turani.
Yeah, it's a good scum list, right?
It is, I like it.
It's a very scummy list. For sure you'll like it. Ah, let's camera. Bad. Save it.
I'm missing Tobias Beckett, actually.
That's true. And that's big works on the board, right? Without Beckett.
And he has big rocks, so I guess Tobias wouldn't be that bad for that list, actually. I'm serious about that.
Double citizen is super loud. Let me adjust your volume a bit.
Low. Yeah.
No problem at all.
Just do that.
Javi, talk a little bit more.
I'm talking.
All right.
But I think on Torkil, if he has only Torkil as a crew carrier, Tobias is not a good pick.
Yeah.
Tobias is only a good pick if you have space left.
All right. I'm hoping the overlay is right because there was a bit of problems with XWS earlier, and I hope I fix that.
How much is the delay so that I know how much I'm delayed for everything?
A minute. I like have a minute of delay. It's the shortest
one. A minute?
Time. Yeah. Okay. I don't think we have cheaters in the chat who are just texting their mates. Even if, right? Like, doesn't matter, I think. Mm. In the end, you have to your decisions on board yourself.
I'm not sure how much people can be in the game. I think it should be as less as possible, isn't it?
Yeah, it should be just the players and maybe a streamer and not any friends in the game, like in my opinion.
Yeah, makes sense. I mean, do you know any of these two players, Dima or Rory?
Not personally. I have to.
I don't know the names as well. I played against some Scottish players, but maybe I know him. Maybe I saw him already in Milton Keynes or something. That's to be expected, but I don't remember the name. But I'm really bad with names.
Yeah, me too. Like, I forget names all the time, sadly. Like, I can remember, lots of X-Wing stuff and points and numbers, right? But, actual names, so hard.
You know, it's easy, because Scott calls me Fabi, you remember my name, you know?
Yeah, right? Like, he's helping out, man. He's helping out so much. Alright. How does it look like, stream? Can we see everything? I think we can, right?
Yeah, it looks good, in my opinion.
I haven't streamed in a long time, so I'm super unprepared to do everything again. Alright, it's Scotland versus Ukraine. And both team captains playing against each other. It's a captain's match.
Is it C for captain?
Yes, C for captain.
Not bad.
I see inside information in the chat. Rory made top 4 in the Tri-City tournament recently, which was hosted by Nickel City, Nick Sperry, and Candid. It was a very fun event.
Okay. I don't know why I didn't play in that one. I'm not the I think online X-Wing tournaments, the big ones, they're really exhausting. It's more than in-person tournaments. I think in-person tournaments can be exhausting as well, but then you grab a beer, you talk with your friends in between games. It's a little bit more leisure time in between, and in online tournaments it's really a tough time schedule and a lot of games, and for me they are really exhausting.
Yeah, They are indeed, like, I agree with you. But on the other hand, you're at home, right? Like, you can go to the bathroom every time you want without any queue. And you have to prepare yourself a little bit, right? Like, I am preparing myself with, like, lots of snacks and drinks on my table, so... It's all right. But I agree with you in real life, because you're talking with people and there are more breaks, actually, because it takes just longer for all the organizational stuff.
Yeah.
And the next thing, especially, like, on big GSP events, right? They're, like, very tightly packed. Oh, the player's already starting. We're too slow. Okay, timer starting. Hello, welcome, everybody, to this game of XTC. It's the first week. It's the kickoff week. I have Fabi from Team Switzerland on my side for commentating.
Hi, and I'm here with Funwalk from Team Germany.
Yes.
You're both not captains.
I'm not good enough for captains. I don't even understand the pairing process, right? Like,
it's so complicated.
I'm just waiting for the results. So.
Yeah.
But apparently in Team Scotland versus Team Ukraine, which is in Group B, the German group, so our future opponents, you're seeing Captain Rory against Captain Dima fighting, and it's a very janky scum list, and you have experience with janky scum lists, right? So talk a little bit about the scum list.
I have some experience with janky scum lists. So we have here Torani Kulda, which has a nasty bullseye ability with cluster missiles, so she can shoot twice with R5TK, which means she can actually shoot friendly targets without hurting them with munitions failsafe. There is no SAM card. You could actually use R5TK to load up SAM before there is anything happening. So you start with a fully loaded SAM, but it doesn't have SAM on Torkil.
No, it doesn't, right? Like, and especially, like, you could use Skargor in Scum Squads to shoot with cluster missiles, right?
Yes. It works as well.
Well, yeah, but because this list, I don't see any synergy with that, right? So why are you using TK here?
I think it's just for the possibility to have a double hit if something is in bullseye.
Okay. Oh,
then he does it twice. He can shoot still. He can, with R5TK, he can take the target lock on the opponent, then shoot twice on an own ship, do no damage on the own ship, and trigger his ability twice.
I see. Oh, okay. That was, I was missing. I see. That's a cool trick, actually. Yes, I like it. Yeah. Love it.
And that's actually to trigger Chostero. Chostero doesn't have more triggers than thermal detonators and Torani, which, in my opinion, is not a lot of triggers for Chostero. I would like to see a Deadman switch on Chostero, just because he triggers on off Deadman switch with his extra attack.
How much points is Deadman switch?
3 points. I mean, it's more expensive, but he's 198, and he doesn't need a bit with his list.
Extra, right? So he has to get rid of one of the upgrades somewhere. I see.
Yeah,
I can see that.
He could even take another false transponder code on Rani. Don't know why he has a bit. I think the list doesn't need one, but he has a bit.
So, I see NW Vader, a good friend. You a lot on Hexad Gaming, giving me a subscription. Thank you very much. That's very much appreciated. A small, tiny little streamer here. Dankeschön. Enjoy your beer emote you will get from that.
So how are you liking the approach of Rory? Rory, it looks like he's trying to approach through the asteroids.
Yeah, right. And that's a big channel in the middle here. Really, really big channel he can use. Right, but I think that's playing into the hands of the aces, right? Because they love it when you're in the center and obstacles are all around you, and then the aces can just flank. So,
Right now he plays into the hands of Dima. Mm-hmm. If he's taking that approach through the two asteroids there where the red hand is.
Yeah, I think I have to agree. Like, with small asteroids, that's not much of a problem. With big ones, you're so limited when you're in the center with moving that the aces will have a good time engaging you, I think. I'm not sure why Rory used the big rocks here, right? Like, he has the Jousty list, he wants to stay information.
Because medium bases always fit.
They always fit.
Yeah, that's why. And Torani is a little bit clumsy. The shift doesn't fly really well. The blue maneuvers is the one straight and two banks or two or three straight. So it's not the best blue maneuvers, so you don't want to get stressed. You have some red actions like the barrel roll, which he probably has to use next turn. If he goes through these rocks. So Torani doesn't like the rocks that much. It's not like, in my opinion, the G1A4 or whatever it is called, the Sucker's ship, yep. Which has a great dial. It's a lot of red, but the dial itself is great. You have a, you have almost every maneuver in that there is. The ship can actually move through obstacles if he can manage the stress.
I see. Yeah, I know the Catch is sometimes playing Torani Scum Jank, and he's using quad jumpers to tractor Torani and to barrel roll him like that.
Yeah, that's a way to do it. Yeah.
Certainly I know, like, when I play him against him, the first time I got surprised by that so much. Like, I was preparing to get out of Bullseye of Torani and doing barrel rolls and all this stuff, and I thought I was super clever. Then he just went in with a quad jumper and moved Torani around. Nickel City, hello in the chat. Oh, I see another subscription from Ludo Lunatic from Canada. Thank you, my friend. Thank you very much. Again, I'm a small-time screamer here. I'm just doing my little stuff and very much appreciated any subscriptions. Ghost, I don't have a tip jar, like, again. I'm just doing it mostly for fun and to annoy Scott. So not enough professional tip jars.
Do you sing the song that I'm a small, small girl in a big, big world or something?
I am
like
rather,
that?
Come on, look at GSP getting all the money. Look at Scott doing his subscription goals. Getting all the
subs. Yeah, I saw that. Maybe he has to do more goals to get out swag subscriptions.
I mean, he should be because that is bringing in the monies.
Yeah, actually it is.
Talking about a bit Team Scotland, they gave themselves a nickname, the Tartan Tuscans from Tatooine of T. And they also sent me like an intro video. I will show it off after the match because it's quite long. So I didn't want to wait about that. So this is the good thing about XTC, right? Like all the teams are preparing like whose stuff and intros and logos.
But aren't the Tartans actually where Ukraine was?
Was it? Oh boy, this is spicy.
The Tartaren, they are from the region around the Black Sea, no?
Spicy, maybe this is just like a little taunt from Team Scotland to Ukraine.
Maybe it is. I'm not 100% sure. That's my Crusader Kings 2 knowledge speaking, you know? Tartans? Maybe that's a German thing.
Maybe.
With the Tartans and then the English, maybe we call it different in German and Tartaren.
Yeah, maybe. Like, I know the tartan is like the Scotland, like the pattern of some of the Scottish clans, you know? Like, each clan has its own pattern for the skirts and everything.
Yeah.
Tartan is like one of the most popular one, famous ones, the blue-green one.
The tartaran in English is Tatars without the R.
Close. Close, but not exactly that.
Yeah. But in German it's Tartaren, so it's written like the...
Oh, Tartar sauce. Very tasty sauce. I know that.
Yes. So, but it looks like Dima is approaching through the rocks there as well. If he's keeping that up. And actually, in my opinion, it's not that bad right now for Rory.
Yeah.
Because Vader is a little bit behind.
Mm-hmm.
So Vader takes a turn or two more if he keeps engaging with Winder and the Inquisitor. So Vader is not in there.
Yeah, right. Like Vader should have maybe turned a bit earlier if he wants to support the fight, right?
Yeah.
Teammates. But there are still options for both Winder and the Inquisitor to turn away from the fight, to disengage for another round, because I think it's a bit too early. Oh, this is an interesting move here from Rory. Look at that.
Oh, going fast, yeah.
Going very probably fast with this bank, boosting, for sure.
Yeah.
He goes for the block on Winder. I think I like this. Yeah. I like this very much.
So Winder cannot really... if Winder disengage, he has to jam out there, I guess.
Yes.
Slam.
Slam out there. Like, slam if he's not there. Disengaging with the move to the left, right, he will get pumped, I think, if he wants to go fast.
Yeah. And with Torkil there, turrets. And he's, I mean, if everything can shoot, he can even get PS killed.
Yes. Oh. I have to agree, though. I like this position for Mori right now. Even if you talked about it earlier, that's in the center of the obstacles. It's not a great place for Scum, but right now.
Yeah, Dima was a little bit too aggressive. Maybe, I mean, it's hard to tell. We didn't see what he's doing, but it looks like it.
But maybe he's juking us out, right? Like, it would be a very cool move for Winda to turn around to the left side and slam around and getting the flank behind the enemy formation.
Yeah, and then it's only Torkil with two dice shooting, which is no problem at all.
Yes. I agree. Yeah, that would be great, right? Just Taro turning in. Tarani will be in the center.
Everything turns in there. Like a free bank to the left with Winder or something, and then
slamming.
Getting out of there. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And he does it. It's 3 hard to the left, but he smelled the roast. He smelled the trap, the kill zone.
Yeah.
And now it's an easy slam out of there.
Yeah, it's a really good... That's... Now Dima saw it. He smelled it, yes. So Rory's position doesn't look that good anymore, suddenly. That's how fast it can go.
Yeah, right. Like, he went for the cool trap, and I like it. I like it very much, but Dima, he knew that. This is the problem right now, right? We talked in the first round. Going to the center. Yeah. Next turn, all the Scottish ships, limited options to turn in, right? They're kind of committed to go after Vader or the Inquiry, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Winda will have... She's a happy girl. She will have a great time next round. Getting into a position to use her advanced proton torpedoes, maybe, or even the normal torpedoes.
Yeah, and that hurts. That hurts.
Yeah, that hurts a lot.
I mean... Dima can turn in with Torani with a 2-hard, but you don't want to do that.
No, not at all, right?
Feels bad. But having the Winder in the back and not facing him with anything,
this could be brutal, but on the other hand, if you manage to catch the Inquiry or Vader next turn, that could be a trade, right? Like, you don't care about Winder if you can kill Vader.
Yeah. I think... What did he do as an action with Advanced Slam? Did he take a target lock?
Yeah, for sure. He took a target lock, and I think it's on Recruit. No.
Because he can probably shoot a torpedo on Torani this turn if he wants to.
I think he took a target lock, right? It's on... I don't see it.
I don't see it.
I don't see it, but...
I'm sure he took a target lock. He did Advanced Slam because there is a stress.
Yeah, and I saw the range checker. So I think
I think it's below Torkil.
Yeah, this could be. It could be below.
Yeah. It's blue and the Torkil is blue. It's hard to see.
Yeah. Could be that, like. Yeah, chat. You will tell us, right? Like, you have it.
Yeah, chat is telling it's on Torkil.
Okay.
Or did he trigger the transponder codes? That's another option.
Oh, he most likely triggered the transponder. Yeah, I see it on.
Yeah, they are gone. Yeah, he triggered the transponder codes.
So he went target lock on just Taro. I see. I like it, right? Like, triggering it now so it doesn't kill you later.
Yeah, that's good.
I will adjust it on the way. So the transponder codes on Torkil are off.
Ooh. Good to know. But
Vader,
but
Vader coming in.
We are talking. And Vader is where we didn't want Winder to go.
Oh, but Vader's now like in a very bad position, man. Especially with Torkil using his ability, right? Like,
oof. Yeah, but Vader will target lock Berul, certainly, no?
Yes, he has to, right? But like, he has afterburners, but afterburners doesn't help you right now, right?
Oh, but why target lock? I would focus, just keep the terminal out, and don't starve yourself of force. Don't know.
Man, I think I even would afterburners to the left and get out of the recruit arc, right?
At least that, yes. Or he can still roll. He could roll.
Yeah, he's rolling.
He's still in the arc. That's not out.
I think he is, right? Like, he should have afterburners first and then rolled to get out.
Yeah. No, Funwalk is not on a delay.
Am I not? I put a delay into the settings, I thought.
There is a delay, but you are not on the delay.
I'm not on
the delay. You are real time.
Yeah, my settings.
So we hope that we are, because we saw the Raider thing pretty at the same time, which means you saw it a minute late, which could be strange.
Stream delay here. 60 seconds, right? 1 minute?
Yeah.
Let's try it again. Like.
Nach Adam Riese, that's 1 minute, I think.
Like, I put it on the settings. I can check after the stream again. Like, maybe I have to press another button, maybe for that. The first time I'm streaming with the
settings. The time for me is now 1 hour left, the in-game time, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, that should be for both of us, right? Like,
no, for you it should be a minute.
Okay, I have to read it up. Because in the settings, I have, like, stream.
We are not in the same time. We should be a minute apart.
Okay, something... I'm sorry, people, but something is wrong with the settings.
So, psh, there is a delay.
Don't tell them.
No. Why are you...
Yeah, most likely I have to press another button, right? Because in the settings, it's like 60 seconds on the stream thing. I can show it.
Yeah, but there is a delay. So everybody's sure
I know,
about that.
I can show it here. It's enabled. 60 seconds.
You see?
Damn it. All right, let's see. First attack, that's Vader. Should
maybe,
be, right?
Maybe you have to restart the stream like Sub Hedgehog is saying too.
Maybe. It's too late now. I will take the punishment for this time.
We missed shooting.
We missed shooting.
Who shot? Vader?
No, Vader is Torkel, right? He should be down. So it was Inquiry into Torkel.
Yeah, zero.
One shield on Torkel. Oh, I told you, I didn't stream for a long time, so I'm just not... I'm tired right now.
I forgive you, but I don't know if that is
worth anything. Banned. I think I will get banned from streaming, oh boy.
You will, I won't. I'm not a streamer.
You're in now, you're part of Team Funwalk.
I'm part of Team Funwalk.
Alright, so one shield on Torkel, that's quite okay.
Yeah.
Now we see Scum shooting back at Vader with all the guns.
Oh.
Two hits.
The thing is, if something like this, I'm doing something like this, I roll blanks with my ship, and I see it coming.
Ooh, Vader's being forced to spend the focus token. That's a good win for Scum here.
Oh, yes, it is.
And Vader's only on one force point. He has only one force point active.
That's what I was saying. He starved himself of force already.
Yes. That's a good shot. Three results from the Fang Fighter. Vader, three agility, one force token. Helotron. One shield on Vader. I think Vader got a bit lucky here, actually. Man, that could have been worse.
For me, it's so strange. For everybody else, it's correct, but you have a little delay. You have a delay in there, so I see everything later. That's why I don't talk about dice, because you are calling them out before I see them roll.
Yeah, let me do the dice, right? You are here for expert commentary and all this.
I do the Scum expert commentary.
Yes. Vader shooting. Oh, Vader with the natties into the Fang Fighter. Get hit, crit, Fang Fighter defending, not range 1, but netties again! Netties into netties, that's fair and balanced.
Oof. And the Fang already spent his focus in the offensive.
And he didn't have Concordia, right? Because range 2, danger.
No,
though.
Range 2.
So actually, it's Rory who got a bit lucky. Both players getting a bit lucky. Vader not getting more damage, and Fang Fighter surviving that.
I know how quick Fang Fighters die.
I know, right? Especially range 2. Like, come on, this is scary.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we like the positions right now? Are we?
So and so. I think Winder is a big problem for Rory, because Winder just eats through his ships.
Yes.
And really fast.
That's a good possibility that Winder will get an advanced proton torpedo off next round, right?
Yeah. Or just proton torpedoes into Torkil with Vader cannot turn in there. But even that Torkil proton torpedoes, it's two dice against four, probably fully, almost full hits. It can hurt the Hawk a lot, the torpedo, because especially the crit, it's only four hull left. It can hurt a lot.
Yes.
But I don't like Vader's position. So Vader has to basically fly away or die.
Yes, absolutely. Vader's disengaging, and he can use afterburners to really get away if he needs to.
Yeah.
What do you do with the Quant Inquiry? The Inquiry is kind of committed, right? Like,
so, yeah, No, it's so hard. I mean, with Torkil, you go just one straight, probably, something like that, or two straight, hide a little bit behind the rock there. Because, where are you going?
I just looked at the force. So Vader's on 2 force. He didn't have to spend his single one last turn.
At the Inquisitor, you mean? Or Vader?
Vader didn't spend any force on defense at all. Like, he
rolled it.
He could have hated, right? Like, he could have used hate, but it's a May, right? No, that's not a May, actually. But on the other hand, we are not allowed to talk with the players here, right? Like, this is a special XTC rules, like in real-life tournaments. Even if you see mistakes and board state problems on the board, the maximum we can do is to call a judge and they will handle that. Like, chatters, spectators, streamers, we are not allowed to talk with the players.
Now, Rory is breaking the rules. He didn't remind Dima that hateful is a May, no? How is that going now? So Rory gets a warning.
I think officially, yeah, maybe, like. I'm just hands off here, right? Like, let the player play, because in real life, in online tournaments, if there's no stream, there will be, like, stuff like that all the time. And we will miss that. But on stream, there's, like, 60 people watching.
I mean, if he forgets hateful, it's not that much of a blunder or not enough to call a judge.
And the thing is, like, with opponent triggers, like, you should be aware of them, right? But man, like, you have to focus on your own damn list, right? Like, yeah, I know in my games, like, sometimes I remember opponent's triggers, sometimes I don't. Like,
it's called sportsmanship.
Yeah. Like, if I know, I will remember them, right? Like, if I know that and see that, I will just tell them that. But it's so easy to miss yourself because it's not your own list. You have to think about your own moves and your own triggers, and your mind is not on that spot, right?
It's good sportsmanship, and there's always, like, fly casual a little bit. It's still here, the fly casual stuff. Sure. And but I know there is mind games as well with it. I mean, you can mind game. If you play Sam or something like that, you can help your opponent with playing mind games. So, I wouldn't shooting him, so I get energy back, I get a target lock. That's quite bad for you. I shoot after you.
Nah, just tell them, like, use your triggers, man. And then they're thinking, why is he telling me to use the trigger? Maybe I don't have to use the trigger. No, like, I agree with you. Like, I'm also, like, fly casual on competitive games. Like, on the last GSP tournament, I let an opponent fly back into the board because he did a miss dial. And it was so early in the game, I was like, this is not fun, really. So, get that damn shit back, man. I don't want to fly like that. And we see a good move here from the Fank, getting very close to Vader.
Yeah, I think so too. So, it's, Vader is probably going down there to escape. Yes. And it could only be the Inquisitor. But if the Inquisitor goes there, there is Torkil waiting for him, and Turani, or probably Aero, and Turani turns down to face Winder.
I agree.
Or just Vader and Winder, actually, because Vader is going down there as well.
I agree, and I love this because the Fang Fighter has a good position for the next turn to chase down Vader and Winder if necessary. Yeah. We see a just Aero target lock from a coordinate action from Torkil. Mm-hmm. That means 5 transponder codes triggers on just Aero, giving a gem to Winder. You see it here, gem on Winder from the 5 transponder codes of just Aero.
Ooh, just Aero doing a talent roll.
Oh, expecting Winder to come back to the fight, right?
Yeah.
And this is a bit critical, in my opinion, because you're splitting up your formation, going all in on Winder.
The arc is really but yeah, I like that Torani move there. Mm-hmm. But if he just does it too hard, what is blue here? Man, I don't know the ship. What is blue? He doesn't have that much blues with the Winder. So he shouldn't have. I don't know.
I don't like the barrel bad. Actually. Like, I think the previous position was quite nice actually.
Yeah, but if he goes too straight and slams into a too hard.
Actually, maybe the barrel was good, right? Because Winder right now has no chance at all to get out of arc.
No, but he can probably boost into slams into range one and put a advanced proton torpedo into it.
But if you slam into range one, that's a bullseye, so.
It is, but it's unmodded.
Yeah, it's range unmodded. One. You just take a damage on the shield, maybe, too. But I think I agree, like, the range one advanced proton torpedo into Rani is quite spicy. And we see the slam.
Oh, but. But if he gets the bullseye.
Oh no, he's jammed. Wait. He's jammed from the fight transponder codes. He can't do the.
Can do nothing. That's true. And if the bullseye ability triggers now, Chosero can shoot twice as well. So it's a bad idea.
Is it bullseye?
To go
no,
there.
I think that's out of bullseye, right? Yeah, that's out.
Oh, it's hard to tell. Is it? I think it is out.
I think it's out too.
Yeah, it is. So that's probably the best decision.
Yeah, but still, that's a free shot from Torani and Chosero here. Actually, Rory being smarter than both of us.
He is.
He is, right?
So we didn't like the position, but it is a really good position. So apparently Rory knows how to play this come list.
Oh, Vader is forced to afterburners now, like for sure.
Yeah.
Man, Rory is that outplaying a little bit Dima, and he's outplaying us commentators, like for sure. Props to him. Yeah.
But with the afterburner, Vader is in a really good position, in my opinion.
Yeah,
he doesn't get shot.
Target lock, everything. Yeah. Fine. Yes, he's using the action for target lock on Torani. Like it. Torani is a good priority target because he's not good in... Well, she's not good in defense. She takes the crits, most likely.
Yeah, she dies really fast. And the crits hurt her a lot.
Yeah.
But... Afterburners already...
One
gone?
Charge down, yeah. Let's update that in the overlay.
Is it two charges down?
One charge down. He didn't afterburn us earlier.
What is in the other? What is the other charge? There are three charges there. I don't see it exactly.
Prockets! Vader has Prockets on board.
So afterburners are gone.
Did he already too? Missed the first
maybe one. In the first turn,
yeah
we missed it.
Probably missed that while talking with you. This is
That's good for Rory, really good.
Yeah. But it's Vader then, H1. Four dice attacks against Torani.
Yeah, but you take that. For Vader without afterburners, you take
high control.
Especially if you rolls like that.
Into a crit. Can use the focus token for all hits. Yeah, does that. That's two hits, two crits. From Vader into Torani.
Yeah,
I don't
can...
think Max has anything range. Blank out by Torani, that's two on the shield.
And two crits.
Crits are... Damage engine, oh boy. This is not good for Torani, especially stress.
Yeah, he hates this.
Direct hit, oh boy.
Direct hit is not even as bad as the damaged engine.
The right, you want to see stun pilot or like soft crits like that.
So he does a 2 bank next turn, which is ill.
Yes. Oh yeah, Mux, Togemux, he used the token on. We see the token here, right? Like guys.
Yeah, on Inquisitor, probably just range 3.
Yeah, it's the only thing he has. Torkel, not Torkel, Torani, one hit into one evade. No damage on Binder.
Mm-hmm.
Chosero next. Oh, blank out! Poor Rory, not getting rewarded here by his, Oh, one hit, not blank out, one hit. But still, not
here's
getting
a target
rewarded.
Lock. Here's a target lock.
Oh, two hits only. Is that enough against Winder? It is, one damage. Winder.
I was talking about this with Raphael a few days ago. If you roll an attack against a target lock chip, and you blank out, most of the people use the target lock to reroll the dice, but is that actually a good decision to do that?
Sometimes not, right? Like, depending on board position and what you're shooting at.
I think most of the times it's probably not the right decision to do.
Yeah,
more than it is.
You want to keep it for double mod, most of. Oh,
yeah,
look at Crud Inquiry. 3 evades against hit and crit from Torkel.
Yeah.
Ace is not taking any damage this round.
It's the curse of the green three greens.
Yes, right.
I hate three greens because I don't roll evades with them. And if I do, it's either I don't or I just roll all evades and nothing dies. It's strange.
It's a Fields bad, man. Fields bad with so many green dice. I'm not a fan.
I don't play that many three greens. That's why I'm probably a little bit talking against them.
Mm-hmm. Alright, again, like, Vader did some heavy damage against Scum, but I think the Fang Fighter is a good card to turn in to follow Vader, right? And then you have Chosero and Torani going for the blocks, maybe? Torani with damage engine is a problem, sadly.
It is. And Torkil, there's stressed in that position, it's not that nice as well, so
yep.
probably stay stressed this turn.
He was really hoping for the bullseye in Winder and didn't get it, so. Yeah. That stress token now. Big. Bomb time. Do we see bombs? Torkoal has bombs. Thermal detonators. I don't. Oh, do we bomb here?
I don't. I wouldn't. Because. Vader is probably not doing a one hard or something in there, no?
Yeah, I agree. Like, Vader should be out. Winder's going out. Like, you're most likely hitting yourself with the bombs.
Maybe he does with Vader, but Vader doesn't have any afterburners left, so Vader is more or less staying where he's flying, so... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this and could be a route fighter. Where you can catch Vader, maybe, like, without afterburners.
And the Fang Fighter is there as well, so... That's really dangerous.
But Ron
the bombs are a little bit far away.
Ron needs to do something here, right? Like, he has to be proactive. Because with so much damage into the Rani. For sure, on the back foot.
Yeah, but the thing is, Torani cannot do much. I think only the two bank to the left fit.
Yeah.
Or he's going one straight. That's basically it. And they are both not the best options to do.
This fits bad for Rory, right? Like 55 points on the ship on Torani, and that ship is pretty much out of the game.
Yeah.
I don't think you drop bombs here.
Maybe if you have something like delayed fuses or something for next turn, but I wouldn't, don't know. Maybe does them. But Justero cannot go that many places, so he can go one straight, fits probably. The one bank to the right fits.
I don't think Justero is a one straight man. You are the scum player, but I think the Urax has.
Oh no, it's a two straight. Yes, it's a two straight. Right? So that doesn't fit.
There was X-Wing.
Yeah, it's not the next. You see, that's you feel which ships I play. I don't play the Kirax.
All right, both players ready. We see movement here. Fang Fighter going for the bank, most likely linked action into boost.
Yeah, which is good.
Yes.
So the Fang Fighter is in a really, really good position. We love the Fang Fighter position. That's good. And the rest is really hard. Yeah, the keeping the stress there can do much more without going out of the game. Mm-hmm. He still has his focus token.
Yeah, he has to go for the bump here with Justero. No way around it. That's why I don't like salad flying, right? Like 1, 2, 3, 4 initiative. It's too complicated for my little brain.
Mm. Yeah, and now he blocks the Vader. If Vader turns into Torani, into Torkil, he blocks Vader. He can shoot Vader, not blocks him. But
all right, let's go Vader Winder.
Vader can be in a bad spot there, actually.
Maybe if he gets blocked there, right?
Yeah.
Winder doing the slam again. Could utilize. Yeah, it's torpedo time, right? You take the target lock. You go onto zero torpedo.
Yeah.
Wrong ship.
So maybe with Vader together, you kill Justero before he shoots.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is certainly a problem.
Yeah.
Boy, man. Looking great for Team Ukraine, for Captain Dima.
It does. But it's a hard matchup for the scum list, actually.
You want to see medium bases or large bases to align your bullseye, right?
Yeah, and against a list like this, you want to herd them away. So you want to hunt them down so that they fly away from you and don't. You are not good in these tight matchups. Your ships are not that maneuverable, except the Fang Fighter.
It's a block from Justero. Do we see guns on target, though? I don't think so, right? Fang Fighter has no guns. For Vader, this is good.
No, but on Winder he has, but he has on Vader, he has nothing. But
yeah. Maybe Torkoal is shooting to Vader, right? Torkoal with a two dice snipe.
And Justero doesn't die.
Yeah.
Which is quite important as well.
Yes.
Yeah, with Torkoal probably on Vader, it's better than on Inquisitor with an evade token through an asteroid.
I think so, right? You're sniping here, yeah. Maybe get a shield or two.
Or just one or two force tokens.
Yeah. But we see the torpedo now from our Lady Winder for dice and target lock.
I learned the fact that two attack dice is good enough. You don't need more.
Can be, right? It can be. But
yeah.
Torpedo first. Two hits, two eyeballs, one reroll from fire control. Into nothing! That's not a good torpedo. Hit crit only into Jostero. Gets nothing! Takes shield and takes the crit. A little bit unlucky for Jostero. The crit is stun pilot. Perfect crit, actually. It's fine.
When was the last time you got the damage because of stun pilot?
Like, I don't think I ever did that, actually.
I cannot remember. Stun pilot is like a there are times when you fly over asteroids.
Oh, Torque is shooting into Ink. I don't like it, man. Rory, come on, snipe Vader.
Snipe Vader.
Yeah, I don't like this decision. It's
just take a force away or two. Yeah.
Like, even if you get lucky, right? Like, you're getting some hits on the Darth Lord. All right, that's nothing.
Yeah, but he's like fully modded.
I know, right? Like,
even
Don't like this decision. But Fang Fighter with the three. Nice snipe into Winder.
Yeah. So now he needs a good roll.
That's a good kinda. Not great. Hit crit is okay. But two evades from Winder and the aces takes nothing this round. Nothing.
And what does Torani do now? Nothing again.
Yeah, right. That he damage engine is so big. Like, that was a heavy crit on Torani.
It's bad.
And like we said earlier, right, like 55 points out of the game for Scum, that's like a big disadvantage.
Mm-hmm. And Toran is even blocking the poor Fang Fighter.
Mm-hmm. Yes, right, the two heart should be blocked, and he wants to do the two heart.
He wants to.
Telling you people, mix initiative, no bueno. Dima, only 28 points in the lead, but on board position, he's like a larger advantage, actually.
Yeah, Lord.
But this can change very quickly. We know aces, right? Like, single mistake Dima makes in the next 38 minutes could lose him the game, actually.
Yeah, especially against Vader already lost the shield, so he's quite close to getting half. So. Mm-hmm. Or killed. Range 1 blank out is a dead Vader.
Yes, sure. But so Roy needs guns on targets, right? This is his big problem in this game. He needs to get more guns on target.
Yeah.
And hello, chat! We're seeing over 70 people watching right now in this match of Scotland versus Ukraine.
Oh, now I'm getting nervous. There are so many. No.
Commentating with me today, Fabi from Team Switzerland. Flying Scum in XTC. And it's really fun work flying for Team Germany with the Resistance.
It's the Resistance!
Yeah. I found my home in X-Wing, right? It's the Resistance, it's T-70s, Rookies, and BBs, and Rose.
I like the BBs are really cool. The pre-move barrel roll, so good.
This is so good, right? They even have jamming beam, right? Like, when I remember about that. That's the block, yeah. Bit rough for Rory, but can he do that? Any lucky roll in Vader will switch the game. Yeah, 70 people judging, right, Chad?
Yeah, but the Celeste Recruit is not in danger there, which is okay.
This is a good move here to protect Torkel from the Grand Inquiry.
Yeah, so the Inquisitor bumps now or flies over Torkel, so that's okay.
Yes.
But Vader will probably go after Torkel because...
Yeah, so maybe it was around to drop the bombs, right? To protect yourself from Vader.
Yeah, at least one. I would have dropped one straight one, range one bomb.
Yes.
Just to make Vader a little bit more scared to go there.
For sure, right? Like, I was a bit surprised that in the system phase there was no bomb trigger.
Yeah. I mean, he has four bombs. Just drop one.
That's right.
You don't always have to drop two of those, I think. Yeah.
And man, Thermodetonators are so strong right now. Like, so cheap are so strong.
Yeah.
I remember back in the days and second edition when it started, everybody was like, proton torpedoes were not torpedoes, proton bombs were cool, seismic charges were cool, but nope. Turns out the thermals are the best.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, world's best talk player, says low frequency 80.
I guess my Hawk play was probably better than my Fang Fighter play. And I have a Fang Fighter in my list, but he dies.
He's
in the first round.
I know the Fang Fighter is the bait in your list.
Yeah. It's a 58 point bait.
Alright, winner. Let me again, this could be another torpedo into Torkel.
I think that's not in range. He flew only two.
You think so? I think it's in range. Let's check in range. Yes, Torkel is in range. I know my TTS here. That's rough for the Hawk.
It is. And Vader probably going in there as well. If he's doing a free hard.
Yeah, that's the reason why you should have dropped the bombs, right? For sure.
Yeah. Now the Inquisitor is in a good position. Everything is always in a good position with Dima. He does it really
Dima
nice.
Is playing amazing. Like props to him, like, for sure.
Yeah.
Oh no, Vader is talent rolling.
But he's not in danger.
He's not in danger, right? Like, there's no bombs. Like, there's no bombs to hit him. There's not.
I think the one bomb would have been all. Would have probably hit him there.
Yeah, maybe.
Right? What did Torkel do? Too straight.
This is interesting, really interesting for Vader. I think he should be kind of... Yeah, he's safe, right? Like, Jostero has no shots.
Maybe the Zealous Recruit, but it's hard to tell.
Zealous Recruit is maybe dying, man.
Yeah, that's true.
Who dies attack from Vader? The Snipe.
Ah.
See? We're telling people, right? The Snipe. Good bad. Fang Fighter. Evade.
The Snipe works.
Nice. Ooh. Finally, Rory getting a bit of luck here.
Thing with the two dice is you already roll hit crit or hit hit. I don't know. It doesn't. There is no other results on two dice rolls. My two dice rolls are better than my sucker's five dice rolls.
I'm actually a lot of times I'm more afraid of the two dice attacks than anything else.
The thing is, the two dice attacks, they happen at the end of the attack round. You already spend all your tokens, and I spend everything with suckers. You have to spend your stuff, and then it's two dice into unmodded stuff. That's the good thing about it. That's why they seem strong.
Mm-hmm.
They are not stronger, but that helps.
The situations happen, right? And another failed torpedo from Winner. Winner using two proton torpedoes to get altogether only four results in the end. This is so unlucky for Dima. Nick is City because he couldn't, right? Did he jam? Not jam, he slammed, right? I think. Winner slammed. He just forgot the token, the disarm token. Yep, here's the.
Yeah,
token.
He slammed.
Couldn't use his target lock. Yep, he was slamming, so he could only use a fire control system with the token. I can't affect the bot state, man. That's the rules. A crit. Vader has to spend the force.
State Chostero.
That was Fang Fighter, most likely. Chostero shouldn't have arc, I think. Right?
The Fang Fighter had arc. Okay.
It was Chostero, actually. It was Chostero. Like, the angle's like a bit skewed.
Yeah.
Alright, nice. So Fang Fighter still has a shot. But Torkel first.
Tokenless. And Torkel is now tokenless, which I don't like as well. Yeah. Oh, poor Torkel.
Poor Torkel. But now the Fang Fighter has another shot into Vader, and he's already... He could also shoot into Winder, right? Who do you shoot here? Range 2 Winder or range 3 Vader?
Keep into Vader. I don't know. I would keep on Vader. Just hope for the best and remove a focus token. Anyway, force token.
It's into Winder. Winder's rolling 2 defense evades. Like, yikes.
Yeah, so it didn't matter at all.
Rory getting lucky on defense, but not getting lucky enough on offense here.
Yeah. But now I must say, the next turn looks good for Rory and Dima, in my opinion.
UA Fighter, I think you're from Ukraine, right? Most likely. Please speak English in this chat, because I can't moderate foreign languages. I'm not smart enough for that.
We can moderate German.
We can moderate German, we can moderate French. I just sent Fabi to that.
Oh, I'm really bad at French. I can do omelette au fromage.
Omelette au fromage, baguette. Oof. Look at that, 3 hits from the Inqui into nothing from the Fang Fighter, most likely. Was it into? No, into Jostero. 3 more into Jostero means Jostero is down to 1. Ah, poor Rory. Poor Rory, man.
Our English is not that good as well, so don't worry. You know, Funwalk is having liquid dreams at night.
I knew that intentionally, right? You know that.
Yeah. Certainly. I mean...
You hear like, we have voice. To mess with the Americans a little bit.
Yeah, I think so too. That's why I didn't call it Nessie, I call it Lochy. You remember? In Gartlic Phone or whatever that is called.
Gartlic Phone is the best game, man.
Yeah. So, now what is happening? There was a little bit flying again. So what do you think? How is the positioning?
So, for Scum, positioning is not bad, right? They can turn in and then try to chase Wind and Vader a little bit. But, man, they're losing too much health without gaining any points.
That's true.
But, again, 28 minutes left, like, lots of time, and again, it's an AC list, right? Any mistake Dima makes and Vader lands in range 1 without tokens will turn the game. So, there are still chances for Roy. He just needs to keep a cool head. He doesn't need to get tilted, right? That's the most important thing right now for Team Scotland. Yes, Torkel should drop all the bombs here. Just drop all the bombs.
Now Torkel has to drop the bombs. But I think the Winter Ghost can do probably does the 2 straight fit? I think it's the for me the perspective is a little bit hard to tell.
That
I
fits
don't
for sure. Like 2 forward is.
And then the 2 hard, or maybe do the 3 forward and then 3 hard for range 1 into Torkel. Is that in there? Because Torkel probably does a 2 hard to the right. He wants to stay in the game, he does it too hard to the right. So can you kill Torkel with Winder?
Yes.
Is the question.
Most likely, yes. But that's the reason why Torkel should move different, right? Like.
Yeah, he should, but he probably doesn't. Because it's not a fast chip. If And he's then out of the game. If he moves to the left.
Don't tell Dima, man. Don't tell Dima, man. It's a secret. It's a secret. Alright, yeah, let's go, like, all Scum has to do now, chasing, putting guns on target. Thinking about the barrel roll linked action here. This position from Fangfighter not great for next round. But do you want
but
that?
But you can do the one heart downwards or upwards next turn.
Yeah, but then you're not looking in the right direction. I think I like the barrel roll, actually.
If Winder goes down hunting Torkel, you are okay. I don't know. I would barrel roll probably as well, but he blocks Jostero if he rolls upward.
You should roll downwards, I think.
Or downwards to,
block to maybe block Inqui, and the next turn you have a better position to chase Vader.
If he's
and
going slow,
I think I would have loved the barrel ship right with the Fing Fighter, like here.
You see, does it too hard?
Yeah, this is dangerous.
It is. So the free straight and the free bank is probably range 1 with Winder and the advanced proton torpedo.
Like, imagine you seeing my hand, like here the Fang Fighter, Winder comes in here. That's a good Fang Fighter shot.
Yeah.
Oh, look at Torani, man, like damage engine. This is so bad for Torani.
And next turn he cannot even K-turn us again. It's not the right angle, doing nothing. It's like...
Base points. It's 55 points based.
It hurts to watch. It's poor Torani.
Slam, 2 forwards, so hard turn slam. I think you're getting hit by bombs here, Winder.
Yeah.
On the other end, that's advanced proton torpedo shot into Torkel. So you take that bomb. Your still shields up.
Yeah, but is he range 1 with the 2 bank?
I think so. I would say I think so, ranged one.
It's close. It can be. For me, it's hard to tell. I have problems with judging the angles.
Yeah, same here, right? Like, in the like game, like, I wouldn't be so confident then on stream talking about that.
Yeah.
I think I take the bombs game, here. That's maximum 2 damage and you have 2 shields. So I take the bombs and then I just delete Torque with the torpedo.
Yeah, but if he is not in range 1, he cannot shoot any torpedoes. He's out.
It's a bit risky, but risk it for the biscuit. He's doing it. He's doing it for sure.
He is doing it. And I think if you do the too hard, you're out of the...
It's the too hard. Oh, not sure if you have Arc right now, right? I think I would have done the 2 bank, actually. 2 bank should be range 1.
Yeah, but I think he wanted to go out of just zeros. So.
This is a mistake. It's maximum 2 damage. Maximum. When your shield's up, you're fine with that. Like, it's most likely just 1 damage on the shield, and you take that any day. Like,
I think he's
too afraid of the bombs. Too afraid.
That's why I ignore bombs.
Yeah, you should, right? Like, with shields up,
yeah,
you should.
Sometimes you should, sometimes you shouldn't, but
That barrel would have been perfect to block.
Would have. Okay. The barrel would have been perfect for everything.
Yeah, right, shooting into Winder, blocking Inqui, like...
Shooting into Winder, blocking the Inquisitor.
Right.
And probably blocking Vader now as well or something.
Yeah,
I don't know where Vader is going.
Rory, man, if you're watching the VOD later, the archives, man. But it's easier said than done in the end, right? Like, I know the feeling.
That's true. If he blocks Vader now with the Sailor's Recruit, he's redeemed. Oh, no.
This is good for Rory, because Vader, no afterburners anymore.
Yeah, that's true. But he has the ability, so...
I think it's the right thing, right? Because Vader can initiative kill Justero, so he rolls to the right, kills Justero on one half. Hello, Peru! Our friend from Group B.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, Justero on one, Justero is there.
Yeah. I think Dima has the game in the back, sadly.
Yeah, and he cannot even shoot on Winder if he takes the damage with the bombs.
Yep.
So, Justero.
This should be like the one-shot kill from Vader into for sure, come on, dude. Get your focus token and... Torkel getting out of the fight, not helping at all, right? Like, Vader on initiative 0 would have been perfect now, but...
And Torani is doing the same thing. Torani is doing her best to come back into the fight, but the ship doesn't want to turn.
Yeah, let's Torkel first. Let's Torkel.
Oh, Sasha, we love you.
Thank you, Sasha. Yeah, we're talking in the Inquiry here, but man, you would love to Torkel, Vader. Oh boy, alright. Still taking the bombs, right? Even with the 2 heart, you're still taking all the bombs.
Yeah.
First roll? Nothing.
But he flew out of the arc of Justero.
Mm-hmm.
And now the bombs do no damage as well.
Second. 1 damage, that's fair. 1 damage from 2 bombs.
Yeah,
1
shield
from
okay.
Winder.
That's.
Yeah, no Justero, no arc, no extra bonus shot. Winder. And now the pain starts. Vader, range 1 into Justero.
Now you pray to the 2 Fortuna.
Yeah, right? Like, full blank out from Vader into target lock, full blank out.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen it happen. I've seen it happen in real life.
It doesn't have to be a full blank out. There's still 2 Vader.
That's
just
not a
blank. Oh! 2 damage.
Fabi! Oh, no! Oh, that's a super dead Justero. Like, super dead.
A lot of crits.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, he forgot to turn his hit into a crit. He could have done that as well, no?
Yes, he could, but I think he's okay with that. But I've seen it before. A Vader shot, range 1, double modified. Full blackout into full blackout. My opponent was not happy at all. He was tilting so much after that.
Would have been worse, yes.
Oh, man. Rory... He needs to get points, right? Like, you don't want to see a tabling here. He can get points, maybe now from Torkel.
At the beginning, it looked so nice. Mm-hmm. That's the thing. But the game is not over yet. There's still a hawk on the table.
Still a hawk on the table. And hawks are the best, right?
Yeah.
Front arc, no shot. So has to use the turret.
Range 1 into... Yep. He needs to net you out a little bit to bank up on his focus tokens again. That would be really nice. Just one time netties.
Yeah, for this Rory. For sure is the time for netties for Rory.
Yeah, just once. That would be nice. Or hit blank. Don't spend them.
It's okay. And yeah. Finally, damage into Winder. No tokens. No, yes, tokens. Focus token. Oh no, no damage. The token was hidden from us under the wing. Man, I'm feeling for Team Scotland here. This is rough.
Yeah, it is.
Tank Fighter, though. That's a lot of hits and crits. Winder, no token anymore. Can we get damage? We can! Finally! Hit that crit into Winder. That's points for Team Scotland, and I'm happy.
That's really good.
Let's hope for a good crit, right? Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
Damage sensor array. That's good. That's good.
Oh, that only focus actions.
Yes.
That's nice against a gunship.
It's nice against gunship, but you already have the target lock on Torkel, right? So Torkel has to be out of range one.
You cannot shoot Torkel next turn, because if you get into Torkel's arc somewhere, you probably die.
Yeah. A little bit back here for Rory, right? Like 31 points with that half points. And if you kill Winder, that's 62. Getting you closer.
And Vader is two points for halving.
Mm-hmm. Problem is, right? Like, we know what Torani is most likely doing. And then Vader's just killing Torani, right?
Yeah, that's the thing. Torani is 27 free points. Which is quite bad.
Super bad. Like, Torani is points...
Disappointing show up.
A points coughing, right? Like, she's like just waiting to get to give points to Team Ukraine.
Yeah.
Yeah, the damage engine on Torani was worse. Like, 100%.
Yeah. One of the worst crits he could have taken there.
It crits? Well, then it should... Wounded Pilot into Torani.
Yeah, you need more crits with Torani.
So overlay on Torani, Wounded Pilot. You don't care about Wounded Pilot too much, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you don't care. Torani can do nothing now. It's what can
Torani has
do?
Torani a talent roll?
No, only a 4K.
Yeah, no talent roll, right? So.
Yeah, and the 4K is probably off the table.
Yeah, can't do that.
That's the thing. The position of Torani, where she was, she couldn't do a 4K in any position.
Mm-hmm.
So he has to do a bank, a hard, a bank.
A hard, and, yeah. Try to get rid of the stress. And
so
then...
bad, yeah. Mm-hmm. And he started stressed with the damaged engine. That's the real problem was that he was stressed already. 100%. Because of the bear roll. So the bear roll wasn't a good idea there then.
Mm-hmm. In the end, like, he tried to
hindsight 22.
Yes, absolutely hindsight. Like, it's easy for us to say it was bad, but he tried for the...
It looked really good at that point.
He tried for the bullseye, really, and he risked it for the biscuit, but this time the biscuit was not there.
It almost worked. But it's hard to catch a Winder into a bullseye
for sure.
When he can still slam around. It's really hard.
For sure.
So if it would have worked heads down, I don't know. We are Germans. We don't speak in English proverbs.
No, we don't, right?
No.
What I am seeing right now is talent roll by the recruit, right? They have a talent roll behind Vader. But it's risky because then Grand Aqueous turning in and killing you, but you have to take the risk. You have to risk it for the biscuit again.
Mm-hmm.
You want your tasty, fluffy biscuit now, not the stale one from last time.
But if the Inquisitor is range 1, it's actually okay for the recruit.
Mm-hmm.
Is the recruit still full?
Yes, recruit is still full. No damage yet. So I think yes, right? You do the 10 roll here, you go up with Torkel. So Torkel is also kind of safe.
Yeah, you go fast with Torkel now. Free bank, no? To just be there.
Yep.
No?
I agree. And yes, and that should be also like a good block on Winder, maybe.
Yeah.
If you like that. And Torani should fly away. Like, don't turn in with Torani, right?
Yeah, just fly as fast as you can.
Yeah, that makes sense.
The chat is saying Torani one hard right, but that blocks nothing, no?
Blocks nothing, and the Vader's just barrel rolling out of arc and killing you. Like, I think you would want to let the imps chase you.
If Vader is barrel rolling, that's actually okay because he spends force for extra actions.
Torkel is stopping, actually. Yeah, no.
Oh, stopping. I like that as well.
Mm-hmm, I like it.
That's good as well.
Mm-hmm, I like it.
It's either going fast or stopping. Stopping is a good decision, probably.
Yeah, as well, right? Because Winner's going into front, and then you shoot into Winner. The Rani flying just away. Mm-hmm, I like it.
Kinda. Just hope Winder goes slow, not fast, because if he goes fast, he's out of there.
Yeah.
Free hard, free straight. Winder is bye-bye.
Winder going left. That's a wounded pilot. I don't think that's a stress with the eyeball. Winder going left, actually. Has to slam out here. Winder taking the business decision here, right? Like, not chasing upwards on the map, not going downwards to...
Yeah, it was a good idea.
It's a good idea, but next time you're dropping bombs again.
So Winder has to go fast again, and he's out of the game then next turn. But Torkel doesn't have that good of a dial to go... cannot start fast, so it's a one bank or one, two,
Winner's
straight,
stopping.
Winner
is stopping. We forgot about damage sensor array. No slam.
Oh, we cannot slam.
We cannot slam. Winner's range one of Torkel.
Oh, that was a genius move.
We are so bad as caster.
Genius.
I will retire after this game. I will just retire and just
will
play
do the
games.
Same.
Yes, right? Like, it doesn't make sense anymore.
I will stop playing Scum.
Yes. I would just contact Piffo and tell him that we will stop streaming XTC, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, but
too bad.
You know what the problem is? There is no crit tokens on the table. That's why we didn't see it.
Right, bot state, right? But we can't tell the players. I would in normal game I would yell at them, right? Like, I would
no, that's
them.
The reason. We didn't see the crit token there, that's it. We are without fault here.
I agree. Yeah. So Vader, no afterburners? Let us check. Does he has a shot? I don't think so. He has no shots, right? It's bad for Vader. He can't barrel to the right.
No shots. Roll. Oh,
this is
really
maybe the route
nice.
For Rory. To like Team Scotland. Where's Team Scotland in the chat? Why didn't Winder repair? If you repair, you are in the same position without any tokens, mate.
and without any tokens in front of four dice, Hawk, you don't want
Vader's
to
forced
that.
To barrel away. This could be the round for Scotland. Can we see the comeback?
And now we see Torkel blanking out, Grand Inquisitor doing crit direct hit into Torani, and Fate Fight blanking out.
Yes.
Something like that is happening now.
It could be possible, right?
But let's hope the best for Rory. Yeah. I'm actually rooting for Rory here.
Yeah, I agree. This is the chance for Scotland. It doesn't mean he wins the game now, but it's a chance. So let's see what will happen. Oh boy.
So Winder is getting to zero. That's just thinking about his triggers. Nothing happens here because Winder cannot shoot anyway.
Grand Inquis using his force ability to the range one attack and running. That's a good roll. Sadly, three. Tarani is on three. Tarani needs results here on board.
Just one.
Can Tarani do it? Can do it. Only one damage on Torani. That's good. As long as you live, right, you are forcing imps to chase you and to shoot into you.
Yeah, and to shoot into you, you are... I mean, Torani is now doing a job. She's a point bunker.
Yes.
A bad one, but she is one.
A bad one, but yeah. Alright, let's go. Scum. Back in business, maybe. Range 1 into Winner. 4 dice against 2.
Oh.
This is maybe the chance for Rory, like...
Yeah, that's an important role here.
Scotland the Brave. How brave are you? It's hit crit. It's a good roll. Winder on defense. One evade only, that's enough. Winder is dead. OMG.
Ooh, very good.
62 points to 71, and we still have the Fang Fighter shot.
Just halving Vader now, no?
Yes.
It's hard.
It's hard, but you can do it. Or do you shoot into Inqui without any mods? One force.
Yeah.
I think you shoot into Inqui, right? Because 2 damage into Inqui is half points, 2 damage into Vader's half points. So
he has to do damage, and it's easier to put damage on the Inquisitor.
Yeah, he should for sure shoot into Inqui here.
Yeah, and he has to do 2 damage anyway on both of them.
Yes.
So
let's see what Fangfighter is doing. Rolling. It's a good roll! It's 3 crit snatties!
Oh man.
Oh boy. Rory? Getting 1 damage only, and it's on Vader. Okay. Not half points yet, but it's a start, man. Oof. boy.
It's only one damage more on Vader, and that's a lot of points then.
Yes.
Oh, 10 minutes left, so the game is still open here.
The game is wide open now.
Not decided here, not at all. Because I think the recruit is now in a really good position.
Yes. Thankfart is in a good position to chase to do damage, and any damage on Vader, right? And even a lucky shot into Inkry for 5 points for the lead in Scotland. Yeah. Man, this feels so good for Rory. Like, I know to be in this position as a player, right? Like, you think you lose the game, you're thinking you're so far behind, but then one single round will turn everything.
Yeah. What do you do with Torkil? Freeze straight in the boost?
As fast as possible, but you're stressed, right?
Yeah, freeze straight is blue, so freeze straight in the boost. Inwards.
I like it.
It's still probably too far away, but it's closer to the what is happening there.
Yes. You want to get
and with Fangfighter just going in there a little bit, no?
Yes, right. Getting close to the aces. You want to hug them.
Yeah.
Alright, this is the chance. Like, Torani will... He will most likely die soon, right? Like...
But what does Vader do in this position here? He can go downwards to... Then you have the Torani there, Torkil there.
Yes.
And if he goes upwards, you can have your Fangfighter there. So
Vader using all his afterburners in the first 1-2 rounds.
Yeah.
Big mistake in the end, in hindsight, right? He would have needed the afterburners the previous round. He would need it now.
So somebody's asking what Gleb does. Gleb is the
coordinating.
The best 2-point upgrade, in my opinion.
It's the best scum coordinator.
Yeah, you can coordinate and you can give the stress away if you want to. Yes. The thing is, if you want to, which is crazy good.
Going slow with Torkil, like, I don't like it too much, but... I agree. It's still okay, right? Like, it's still okay for chasing.
Yeah, yeah. But then if you go slow, fill up your tokens. And don't stress.
Oh, perfect move to Rani. Fits behind the rock. Still can do the action to defend.
Yeah.
Rani wants to keep alive, like, oof.
Yeah, Torani probably safe from the Inquisitor now.
Mm-hmm. I think the recruit should have banked more to the right to protect Torani, right, in the end?
Yeah, I would have done a 2-bank to the right.
Look at that, Inqui. Intended bump. Yeah, that's a shot into Celus recruit, but a ranged one shot, so not sure if that's good.
Not sure if recruit can shoot back, no?
Yes.
And Torani is there as well, so they can probably PS kill the recruit if they want to. You can shoot Vader as well.
No, he's barreling for sure. Vader wants to get out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that should be alright. Like, let's think. Yeah, Vader's out, but you have chances to Inkry now. And Torani can survive again, right? Like, this is most likely an obstructed shot maybe from Vader. Rory, man, your dice has to hold now. Like, your dice has to be very brave.
That can be a dead Inquisitor.
Oh, Torkil.
Really dangerous for the Inquisitor there.
Yeah. This was not a good bump, most likely, right? Range 1 of a Fangfighter.
Nope.
Okay, let's see what happens. Vader the first.
The Fangfighter probably doesn't take any damage.
Mm-hmm. Obstructed! Torani! Feels a bit alive. 2 health point. Torani.
I'm taking crits again. I think Torani dies now.
Super bad roll from Vader.
Oh!
Spending all his force depleted for next round. Using the target lock for reroll. Oh boy, this is a dangerous game Dima is playing.
It is.
Gets the result though. 3 results from Dima. Torani would love to see 2 results back on defense.
Yeah.
Gets it! 2 results! Takes the crit. Anything but the direct is okay.
Wow, crazy, crazy. This now Torani can even do a 4k turn if he wants to.
Yeah. Weapons! Not the best, but it's okay. You're still alive.
Yeah, so you don't do a 4k turn, you just fly away.
Yeah, you're just flying away now, right? Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh boy.
So now the important stuff. Can it kill? What was that? Your background?
I adjusted the overlay and went shortly to my background.
Yeah.
Man. Rani is still alive. Still points fortress. Torkil into Inquiry. Oh, Torkil! Has the target lock from earlier.
Just use it.
3 results! Inqui, only the force for defense. Has to spend. Gets 1 damage, 1 shield on Inqui. This game is on the wire. Oh my godness. It's out! Fabi, it's out from the Fangfighter! It's out! Oh no, it's out. This is big! Oh no, Rory!
So the bump was really good. What were we talking about?
Right in hindsight, the bump. Oh no, no shots.
Oh.
But the good thing for Fangfighter, you have the focus for defense and Concordia. You shouldn't take any damage here, right?
No, you shouldn't.
How do you spend the force? It's risky. I wouldn't spend it, actually. Like, with Concordia, with...
No, you don't.
He spends it. Force depleted.
He spends it?
Fully force depleted. Yeah, easy.
If Concordia. He's lucky, he halves him.
Yeah, no, this was not a good force spend here, for sure.
No, it wasn't.
Dima... Oh boy, this is so close now. 5 minutes left on the clock. Super close game. Dima, fully force depleted. Vader and Inqui next round, only one force token. Tarani is out, right? You go fast, you go forward. You go forward and focus.
And both one hull of half.
Oh boy!
So you probably cannot shoot Vader.
No, but you want to shoot focus fire into Inqui maybe. Oh man, this game. Dima in the lead, but just barely. He needs to kill Tarani to get a buffer. Can he? I don't think so, right? Can Vader get around the rock with a 3-heart?
No, but the I don't think...
Close,
no,
right?
No, maybe. It's close.
Maybe.
No. I know we... No, I don't think so now. Is it? I don't know. I'm bad at X-Wing.
Oh, this is risky, because Vader, right? If you land on that rock and roll that hit or crit, you will cry for sure.
Maybe he fits there, but...
I think it fits, right? I think it fits. So what? So you know Vader's most likely doing the 3-heart. What will you do with Tarani? Can you turn in? Can't, right?
You're not you are stressed and you cannot barrel roll. If he didn't have that dumb crit, he could do that.
Oh, but this game, man. Like, oh.
Maybe he can do the 3-heart to the left or something like that. Which is like... Or with Tarani.
I think Vader going for the 1-heart. Bumps.
That's okay.
Yeah, I think it's okay. It's blocking maybe Inqui.
Yeah, because the Torkin is there, just target lock. Or take the focus, doesn't
right,
matter.
Tarani is just running, right? Tarani is just running. Oh boy.
Maybe the 3-heart upwards, just to hope Vader is doing the 3-heart in there. I don't know if it fits. If it doesn't fit, it's...
Yeah, let's see. Inqui first. Inqui, turning game. In? Or do you go forward? Turning in, okay. This is a good chance for Dima now. Killing Tarani to get more points. Big thing for him. Vader, what do you do, Vader? Where do you land? Rebank to right. Ah, that fits and it's perfect and you still have Arc, right? Okay, Tarani should be dead from this. But there's Fangfighter shooting and there's Torkel shooting. And for Rory, he needs to roll fast, right? If he loses Tarani and doesn't get points, he needs...
Yeah, he needs a round more.
Oh, the round barrel from Vader!
Really important.
Barrel from Vader! Target lock, okay. Yeah, this should be a dead Tarani. And now it's all up to Torkel, actually.
But now there is a tokenless Vader where Torkel can shoot.
Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, man! And half Vader is more points than Tarani, no?
I think,
it?
Right? I think... Oh.
It's 42?
Let's simulate it. I will do half points on... Half points on Vader and kill Tarani. That's... The lead for Team Scotland, actually.
Oh!
That would be the lead for Team Scotland.
Oh, man.
Yes, oh, man, right? Okay, first shot. Inqui into Tarani, range 3.
There can even be a round more.
Hit crit! Oh, Tarani again needs all results. Doesn't get it this time, Tarani is dead. Okay, Tarani
it's is okay
dead.
That Tarani dies now, because now Torkil shoots, and that should be less than a minute. So yes. He has a turn more, no?
Yeah, Rory should be super fast now. He should be shooting Vader super quick and then just go for another round.
Yeah.
No, don't attack Inqui, attack Vader. 5 points on Vader is enough for the lead. Don't attack Inqui, Rory. Believe me.
Not an Inquisitor with Evade and
Force
Token.
No, you shoot into Vader, yeah, let's go.
Oh.
Hit, 2 hits only. 2 hits only. Ada, defense. No force, nothing. Gets the 2 evades! Vader takes no damage! Alright, let's go, dials down!
Is it dials down actually, or what was the...
It's dials down. It's like one dial should be flipped and then you're on the planning phase. Like, come on. Like, we want... Like, the players will decide, right? Like, yeah, it's dials down. So, next round. One round more. Rory has the chance. Dials are down. Yeah, don't check, man. Don't check at all. Like, do the dials, man. Yeah, he got it. He got the dial.
Yeah, there is one red. Change it now.
Yeah, he can change it. Easy.
It was red once. He can change the
Yeah, it's perfect.
Doesn't
it's
matter.
Well done, Hutt. He needs that round, and he needs 1 damage on Inqui or 1 damage on Vader. Vader's force depleted. No afterburners. But he's protected by that rock here, right? Like.
But Vader goes fast now. Vader is out 100%. There, isn't he?
Can the recruit somehow chase Vader? Like 3 bank? Then boost? Boy, this guy.
And the Inquisitor just going down into Torkoal.
Yeah,
because the Torkoal goes fast, you can bump Torkoal.
Yeah, you bump into Torkoal and you're fine.
Yeah.
Oh, so man, my turn to Vader from Torkoal. Like, one result two. More. Run more.
This is... But if he goes fast with the Inquisitor, Torkoal has problems there.
Mm-hmm. Let's see here. Fangfighter is in a good position to maybe hit Vader.
Yeah, the Fangfighter is good there for Vader. He can take a shot probably into Vader. And Torkoal won straight.
No, that was not one. That was a 3 bank.
Yeah, it was. But now the Inquisitor just bumps Torkoal.
No, just fly over. Oh no, the Inqui is not in good position at all. But he should...
No, not at all. Yeah, evade.
Not even evading, right? He's flying away, get more range. But Vader 5 out. Okay. Can he barrel roll somewhere? No, there's still shots. Like, Vader cannot get out, right?
No.
Oh boy, this is gonna be the last round and the last shots deciding the game.
Oh man.
Yeah, he's running away, increasing his chances. But Rory has the game in his hand. Good rolls to kill Vader, or to get one single damage on Vader is enough. Take the lead.
Yes, too. And the Inquisitor is... The focus token is not good, in my opinion. The range one from the...
I don't think you care, right? Everybody shoots Vader here,
with
right?
The evade...
Everybody shoots Vader, I think. I don't think you shoot into Inquisitor. Like, focus fire on Vader. Like, strip the focus token and the next shot gets the damage on Vader.
Yeah, he's forceless. Yeah, just shoot him.
Alright. Torkoal first. Into Vader. Range 3. Obstructed. Torkoal. Only one! It's not enough! Oh no, Rory!
Maybe it is.
I don't think so. Oh no, Rory! Okay, this is the shot for the game. Fangfighter. Range 3. Into Vader with the focus token.
Oh man.
For the win. Rory.
Just 3 results and 2 blanks.
He gets his results. This was the best outcome yet. But he needs... Blanks.
Oh, 2 blanks.
Blanks! That is the blanks! This is the game for Rory! 1 damage on Vader! This is the damage on Vader! This is the game for Scotland!
Crazy! I was rooting for the scum list! I told you in the beginning, the scum will win!
What a steal in the last shot of the game! Fangfighter, the hero of scum! The hero of Scotland! Getting a medal from the Scottish Parliament, for sure.
Yeah, certainly.
Oh no, crazy. Man, Dima playing amazing, but then, in the end, just running out of gas. No afterburns for Vader to fly away.
Yeah, that hurt him in the late game. The early afterburners, it was really good in the beginning.
Yeah. There were a couple of situations where Vader afterburning away would have sealed the game, right? But man.
Yeah.
Oh boy, what a first game of the week for XTC here. Like, if every game of XTC will be like that, I will be dead. After week 2.
Yeah. No, it was really nice. Dima played really good. Rory did a good job there.
For sure.
It was a really hard game for both of them, actually.
Yeah. This was very well flown by both players. Like, they were outplaying us commentator, for sure.
Yeah.
Oh boy, I'm a bit concerned, actually, in Group B right now, looking at Dima and Rory playing. You know what I mean? Like, they're doing great.
Yeah, but maybe they are the captains. They have to be great, no?
You think so? Like, I don't think our captain is not great. Oh, I'm concerned for Team Germany suddenly. This was very solid flying. This is the win for Scotland. Like, oh, but what a comeback.
Oh, now do we play the Scottish? Do they have an anthem? You have to God Save the Queen?
No. We don't play that.
That's a little bit boring, no?
We're playing Scotland the Brave, right?
Scotland the Brave? We could do Unten am Jungen Rhein, the Liechtensteiner anthem. No, it's the same melody like the English.
No Liechtenstein stuff. That's good old Scottish stuff here.
Yeah.
Alright.
We need a Scottish anthem now.
Yeah, I'm loading it.
Ah, that's good.
I hope I don't get DMCA strike, but I don't care anymore. It's all for Scotland.
Maybe you have to play it backwards. Flower of Scotland. I don't know that many Scottish songs.
I'm already playing it in the background, so you don't hear it because you're on Discord with me. But
that's why you don't hear it. I turned the sound off.
Chat is hearing good Scottish music. I don't care anymore, Marcel. Give me the strikes! And nobody's gonna strike Scottish pipes, right?
Yeah, they don't know who played this, no?
Right.
Is that a copyrighted song, is it?
Yeah, most likely. Like, they have like bots to do that. Alright, it's enough. No strikes anymore. But Scotland wins this amazing match with the very last shot of the game. And thank you very much, Rory, captain of Team Scotland. Thank you very much, Dima, captain of Team Ukraine. What a heartbreak. And thank you much, Fabi, for commentating with me. This was very fun. We can do it again. I will invite you back.
And thank you, Funwalk, for hosting the game.
I'm really super happy that I got this game, because this was the best game of XTC ever.
Maybe?
No, I'm for sure. Like, no game will better than this.
You know, game will beat this?
It's actually hard to do. This was amazing.
It was really nice.
All right, chat. Thank you very much for joining us with over 80 people watching in the end. This is very good. Like, XTC is very good for my streaming numbers.
Yeah, and you get some subscribers as well. The big money. You can run to the bank with this or something like that.
Give me a couple of weeks and I'm going to buy Hexile Gaming. No worries.
Yeah.
All right, no so worries, it's though. Time to say goodbye. I need something to drink and eat because I'm so done.
Ciao, Zimmer.
See ya.